Praise the Lord, everybody. Come on in. Come on in tonight. We have in Bible study. It's Wednesday night. Come on in. Come on in. We want you to participate with us tonight. We thank God for his glory. We thank God for his mercy. And we give God the glory tonight because God has been good to us. And we love you. We appreciate you. And we want you to subscribe to the YouTube channel tonight. We want you to come on in and turn up your Facebook pages and tell somebody, text a friend. Tell them that the New Beginning Faith and Ministry Bible Study Church is on tonight. And we want you to come on and be our special guest tonight. And so I honor God tonight, for God is good and his mercy endureth forever. Come on, we want you to shabak the Lord tonight. Come on. Can't stop, won't stop praising his name. Come on, say it with me. Can't stop, won't stop praising his name. Come on and say it with me. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God tonight. God is good and God is greatly to be praised. Oh, come on. We appreciate you tonight for coming on in. We want you to participate with us tonight as we bring the bread of life to you. We want you to be hungry for the word of God. We want you to have your heart open. We want your ears to be open that you may be able to digest the word of God, that it will be good to you tonight. And so we honor God tonight. We honor his presence tonight. And we are live in the studio.
Come on.
Come on, somebody. We are live in the studio tonight. It's a good thing to be in the studio tonight. And we thank God for being here in the fresh presence of you tonight, that we're going to give you a word. And the word is not going to be coming from me, but it's going to be coming from Apostle Venus Ponder tonight, that she can preach the word, she can teach the word, and she can prophetically speak to you. She can prophetically speak to you in a way that you never imagine. She can speak to you because the Lord, it is the Lord that is speaking through her. Come on, somebody. Come on and give God the praise. Come on and shabak the Lord tonight. I want to bring some to your attention tonight. I want to, you know, God has been dealing with me with some things, and I remember that he was talking to me one time, and it came back to my remembrance, and he began to tell me, he said, my time, my turn. Okay. Come on, somebody. My time, my turn. But the other part that goes with it, he told me, my time, my turn. But the other part that goes with it, he said, now, if you don't do your part, whose fault is it?
Come on, Apostle.
My time, my turn. Jesus. And I began to think about that thing, you know, when I was a young guy, and I used to see all these guys that played ball for my high school and everything, and they used to tote the bag, and I wanted to tote that bag so bad. I wanted to make sure I carried that bag. You know, when I got a little older, I wanted to make sure I carried that bag, and I wanted to make sure that I practiced and everything, and I put the time in to be at that particular time in my life. And when I got to that line, got to that particular time in my life, God began to tell me, my time, my turn.
Jesus.
My time, my turn. And guess what he said? Now, I'm giving you your time, and now it's your turn. But if you don't do your part, whose fault is it?
Oh my God.
Come on, somebody. I'm telling you tonight, God told me to tell you it's your time and it's your turn.
Come on, Apostle.
And when it's your time and when it's your turn, when it's time, your time and your turn for deliverance, guess what? If you don't get it, whose fault is it?
That's right, Apostle.
When it's your turn and when it's your time, when it's time for you to get the new anointing that God has placed on your life, if you don't do your part, whose fault is it?
That's right, sir.
I'm trying to tell you tonight God said, it's your time and it's your turn.
Oh my God, come on, Apostle.
Now we've got to do our part, and we do our part. God said, I'm putting you in a situation, I'm putting you in a place, I'm putting you in a predicament. That's what, it's your time and it's your turn. But you've got to participate in it, and you've got to do your part. And if you don't do your part, whose fault is it?
My God, come on.
Come on and give God a praise. We bless the Lord tonight because God is good. I'm trying to tell you tonight, God has been dealing with us and God has been speaking to us, and God will speak to you profoundly.
Yes, he will.
God will give you a word, and guess what? He'll bring back things back to your remembrance. And sometimes, you know what? We forget, but God does not forget. We forget, but the Holy Ghost don't forget.
Yes.
Oh, come on tonight. We're live in the studio. Text a friend. Call a friend. Tell them to subscribe to the YouTube channel tonight, because the word of the Lord is going on. That is a spread on the table tonight, and you are ready to be fed tonight. There is a spread, and whatever you want on the table tonight is on the table.
Yes.
And we want you to get everything that's on the table tonight, because when it's on the table tonight, that you can get the word of God, that you can feast in the word of God. And the word of God is going to do something for you. It's going to turn your life around. It's going to transform you. It's going to make sure that you're doing what you need to do. And God is going to do some miraculous thing in your life. It is your turn and it's your time.
Jesus.
Come on, somebody. It is your time and it's your turn tonight. Oh, come on, somebody. Give God the praise tonight. God has been good, and his mercy endured forever. I love the Lord tonight. Don't you love him?
Jesus.
Don't you love him tonight? I love him tonight. I love him when he wakes me up in the morning, when he breathes the breath of fresh air on me. I give God the praise. I won't stop, can't stop praising his name.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank God for you tuning in tonight. We are live in the studio tonight, and the word of the Lord will be coming forth. And I'm going to move to the side and let Apostle Venus Ponder give you the bread of life.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Come on in. Come on in. It's time to praise the Lord. Come on in. Come on in. Glory. Hallelujah. For the Lord is moving by his power. The Lord is moving by his spirit. Amen. And our apostle, amen, has already decreed and declared, amen, that the Lord has spoken to him and say, it is my time. It is my turn. Come on and say it with me. It is my time and it is my turn. Glory, hallelujah. What do that mean? It's time for me to be delivered. It's time for me to be set free. It's time for me, amen, to be elevated in the things of God. Amen. It's my time, amen, to walk in the fullness of God. Amen. It's my time, amen, to be blessed. Amen. Glory. And some of you need to tell the truth tonight. Amen. That it is my time to be delivered. Yes, glory. Lord. Whatever you're going through tonight, it's your time to be set free. It's your time to be delivered. Amen. From the forces of people. Amen. From standing under pressure. Glory. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
It's your turn.
Hallelujah.
Amen. It's your time. Mm-hmm. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. And God is moving by his spirit. Glory. Hallelujah. And so listen. Amen. Do me a favor. Go ahead on and share this broadcast. Come on. Amen. Share it. Share it. Somebody need to hear this word. Somebody else, amen, other than yourself will be encouraged. So come on. Why don't you hit the share button? Share this broadcast. Amen. Follow us. Amen. And release some hearts. Amen. Release some lights. Amen. We also want you, amen, to subscribe. Amen. To the New Beginning YouTube channel. Glory. Hallelujah. And for those of you, amen, you can participate back with Apostle James and myself. Amen. We're live. amen, in the studio room, amen, of New Beginning Faith Ministry Church, amen, and we're declaring the word of God, amen, glory, not only are we declaring the word of God, we're standing on the word of God, amen, because the word of God said that his word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, glory, hallelujah, and we know that God is going to do something. Glory, hallelujah. So I need for you to get ready. Amen. Come on, get ready. Yes, Lord. Come on. It's your time. It's your time to be healed. It's your time to be delivered. Amen. It's your time for advancement. Amen. It's your time, amen, to get wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. I don't care what it is tonight. Amen. You need to say, it is my turn. Amen. And it's my time. Amen. As the apostle said, it's my time and it's my turn. Amen. Glory, hallelujah. So we're excited about what God has been saying to us, because God has been giving us strategies. Why? So that we can undermine the plot and the plan of the enemy. Glory, hallelujah. So that's the Tabat Sheketa da Bosoto Rababasha Hikaya da Boso. The Lord has to give you a strategy. When it's your time and your turn, God has to give you words of wisdom. Amen. So you can stand and break the back of the enemy. Glory, hallelujah. On Sunday, I preached about, amen, standing under pressure. Tonight, I'm going to bring part two of standing under pressure. Yes, come on, come on, Shatai. And because it is your time and your turn, amen, I'm going to show you how to stand under pressure and break the back of the enemy. God has given us a strategic word, and God has given us revelation, amen, on how we can stand, amen, because the anointing upon our life is a yoke-destroying anointing. What God has placed in you and I, amen, he placed the Holy Ghost, amen. And he just give you no kadanabasha. And he didn't just give you any type of Holy Ghost. He gave you the Holy Ghost, amen, with power. Come on. Your Holy Ghost got power. It got power. Amen. If you will rest upon, if you will, amen, allow the Holy Ghost in you, amen, to operate in you, amen, the Holy Ghost in you is full of power. Come on, it's full of power. Amen. Glory. Amen. And so I honor God because God began to deal with me. Glory. Hallelujah. And as I said to you all on Sunday, a part of standing under pressure, amen, it is so that God can make and mold you. Oh my God. It is so, amen, that the purest and the authentic all of God may be birthed out of you. While you're under pressure, glory, hallelujah. And so tonight, I want to give you some strategies. I want to give you four strategies for while you under pressure, amen, that you'll stand on the word of God and watch God break these things. Why? Because let me tell you something, amen, if you believe the word of God, amen, and science tells us that two matters cannot occupy the same space. Yes, Lord. Did y'all hear me? Two things cannot occupy the same space. And so if the power of God is going to operate, then the power of darkness, amen, got to be put under, under your feet. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. And so listen, God says in Jeremiah, amen, 23 and 29, Come on, we're talking about this breaker's anointing. Amen. We already know that God has been decreeing and declaring, amen, that God was releasing a breaker's anointing. Amen. He's releasing a breaker's anointing because it's your time, it's your term. Mm-hmm. And Jeremiah 29 and 23 say, "Is not my message like a fire, says the Lord? Is it like a hammer that smashes a rock?" What are you talking about, Apostle? God is saying, no, while you're standing under pressure, amen, that the word of God will go in like a fire. And he said, listen, it's going to be like a hammer. Amen. It's going to be like a hammer that's wrapped in fire. And God said, I'm going to smash every rock. I'm going to loose every shackle. Amen. I'm going to break every yoke of bondage. But as I said to you on Sunday, but the first person that got to come in agreement with the word is you. You got to come in agreement with the word. You got to line up and obey God. Amen. In order for God to break some things in you. And so God was telling me, he said, now you told them and you showed them, amen, where is this pressure coming from? Now God said, you got to go out and teach them how to stand, amen, by using the principles of me. By using the principles of me. Glory, hallelujah. In order for you to stand under pressure, amen, point number one, amen, you got to seek the kingdom. Amen. If God is going to break anything, amen, in your life, amen, while you're standing under pressure, amen, you got to seek the kingdom. Come on and let's go to my favorite scripture, Matthew 6 and 33. Glory, hallelujah. I'm excited about this word.
Thank you, Jesus.
Seek first God's kingdom and what God wants. Then all of your other needs will be met as well. God said, listen, amen. The strategy that I'm giving you, why the enemy is trying to put you under pressure, is to tell you, is to seek me. If you would seek me, seek everything about me. Seek me, amen, and spend time with me. Because God said, yes, I said that this is your time. And this is your turn. But in order to do that, you got to seek me. Mm-hmm. You got to seek me. And when you seek God's kingdom and what God wants, not what you want, what God's want. And then God said, and then your all other needs will be met as well. What are you talking about, Apostle Venus? I'm talking about that when you seek God, God said everything else you need, I'm going to automatically give it to you. You don't have to seek those things. The only thing you need to do is seek God. Don't seek approval from people. Don't seek, amen, glory. Don't seek approval from nobody but God, because God knows the heart of every person. God already know, amen, whether a person is using you. God already know if a person's motive is right. God already know, amen, if a door is open up for you, whether that was the door that God opened or a door that the enemy opened.
Yes, Lord.
Because you're seeking things. You all need to stop seeking things and seek the Father. Glory, hallelujah. Not only that, he says, listen, once you seek me, amen. He go to Romans, amen. Romans, y'all need to put these scriptures because these are some powerful scriptures. Romans 13, amen, verses 11 through 14. Come on, Romans. Glory, hallelujah. Listen, this is why God said that you got to seek me. He said, do this because we're living in an important time. It is now time for you to wake up from your sleep, because our salvation is nearer now than when we first believe. The night is almost finished and the day is almost here. So we should stop doing things that belongs to darkness and take up the weapons used for fighting, for fighting in the light. Let us live a right way. Let people who belong to the day, we should not have wild parties or get drunk. There should not be no sexual sin of any kind, no fighting or jealousy. But clothe yourself with the Lord Jesus Christ and forget about satisfying your sinful self. God says, listen, y'all got to forget about satisfying your sinful self. Stop trying to, amen, please your flesh. Stop trying to please your mind. Glory, hallelujah, because it's fleshly too. When you don't have on the mind of Christ, God said, listen, it's time, amen, that you come out of darkness, come in the light and do the things right. Amen, glory. He said it's time for you to pick up your weapons of the light. Pick up your weapons of the light. What is your weapons of the light? The word of God. The word of God is going to be the weapon that you're going to use to fight the darkness while you're standing under pressure. My God. He said, but clothe yourself with the Lord Jesus Christ and forget about satisfying your sinful self. Mm-hmm. Glory. He even talked about don't be drunkard. Don't do all of these things because these are the things of the enemy. Mm-hmm. Glory. By show. Hallelujah. These are the things of your sinful nature. Amen. And one of the things, if you're going to use the word of God like a hammer, a fiery hammer, then amen, you got to seek God. You got to know God's standard. God began to tell me, he said, listen, there's a standard in me. Glory, hallelujah. And so many people, amen, don't want to live the standard of God. Amen. Because the world have tricked you. The world has tricked you, amen, that you can come to God any kind of way. Yes, he said, come as you are. But when you come as you are, you can't stay that way once you receive the truth. Thank you, Lord. Glory, hallelujah. And so the first thing you got to do is seek the kingdom. You got to cast this other stuff off of you. All of this darkness. Amen. You got to cast out all of the unrighteous living. Hey, Baba Shoto. All of the unrighteous language. Mm-hmm. Amen. You got to cast this stuff out for you. Amen. Glory. Because now you're going to clothe yourself. Amen. In God. Glory. Hallelujah. John. Amen. First John. Amen. 1:5-8. Glory. Here is the message we have. We have heard from Christ and now announce to you, God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. Come on. So if we have fellowship with God, but we continue in darkness, we are liars and do not follow the truth. But if we live in the light, as God is the light, we can share fellowship with each other. Then the blood of Jesus, God's Son, cleanses us from every sin. Glory. If we say we have no sin, we are fooling ourselves and the truth is not in us. It's not the truth. And the truth is not in us. God is saying, listen, but if we live in the light, as God is the light. See, a part of you seeking God is so that you can come into the light. God wants to bring you out of darkness and into the light. He wants to clothe you, amen. And God is telling you, wake up out of sleep. Open up your eyes so you can receive. receive the truth. Amen. And you can come out of these things. God is calling the body of Christ to come out of these things that is not of him. Stop bringing this darkness into the church and thinking you can still operate in it. Glory, hallelujah. But God is calling you to come out. One of the strategies, amen, in you seeking God, amen, is you got to disconnect yourself from everything that is not like God. That's why God said, come out and be ye separated, amen, glory. Be ye separated from these things, amen, glory. And especially if you want God to bring you out of the pressure of the world. You got to seek him, because the only way God is going to break this thing, amen, glory, hallelujah, is by you seeking him and you being clothed and you coming into right relationship.
Yes, God.
Because God wants to break the erroneous relationships, amen, that you connected yourself to before you understood who you were in Christ. Come on, somebody say amen. Amen. Number two, amen. You got to walk in truth. You got to walk in truth. Amen. Another thing, amen. In order for you to stand under the pressure, amen, and for God to break some things, remember now, I'm saying God is releasing the breaker's anointing. Come on, somebody, amen. Came out show. Come on, somebody say breaker's anointing. It got to break tonight. I decree tonight, even as I'm teaching, something in you is going to break tonight. Something that the enemy thought that he was going to use the pressure of what you've been through, amen, to hold you bound and to fleece you. Tonight I declare that it shall be broken in the name of Jesus. Why? Because you get because you're going to walk in truth. You're going to receive the word of God and you're going to walk in truth. And when you start walking in truth, then God's word, amen, is going to break up the foul things in your life.
My God,
my God. Jesus Christ said, you should know the truth and the truth shall make you free. Amen. That's John, amen, 8 and 32. Come on, go to John 8 and 32. Hey, God, John 8 and 32. Glory, hallelujah. Father, we thank you.
Yes,
amen. You should know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Mm. Amen. That's a wonderful promise that we can take seriously, especially when you feel the need for some sort of healing. Amen. When you need healing, amen. Whether the difficult is in an injury, an illness, financial hardship, mm-hmm. amen, a troubled relationship, amen, glory. Even when you're depressed, amen, and oppressed, because one of the things that the enemy likes to do, amen, glory, when you're standing under pressure, amen, he loves to release the spirit of depression upon you. He loves to release the spirit of oppression upon you. He loves to release a spirit of bondage upon you. Why? Because he wants you to stay in. He don't want you to break free. He don't want you to believe the word of God. Why? Because the enemy has been feeding you nothing but lies. So one of the ways, the strategy is you got to walk in truth. Because when you start speaking truth, and I know truth may hurt, when you declare truth and you tell the truth about a situation, amen, no matter what it is, that's when God can help you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, God.
Yeah, make it sure. That's when God can help you the most. When you start declaring truth, when you receive truth, even when you don't want to, when you receive truth, that's how God can help you. Glory, hallelujah. Psalms, amen, 119, amen, verses 133 through 136. Come on, we walking in truth tonight, because many of you cannot be delivered and set free, amen, because first of all, you don't want to tell yourself the truth. You don't want to walk in truth, amen. And it can be as simple as, I need help. I need deliverance.
Jesus.
Glory. Hallelujah. Psalms 119 and 33 says, God, my step, as you promised. Don't let any sin control me. Mm. Listen, you got to ask God to guide your steps as he promised. Then you got to ask God, don't let any sin control me. Do y'all not understand that sin has the ability to control you?
That's right.
When sin owns you, it controls you. Now you're wondering why, amen, you can't let this go. Huh? Why? Because the sin owns you.
My God,
Jesus. And you need God, amen, to break the agreement that you had with sin.
Yes.
You came in agreement with sin when you didn't know who you were.
Yes, God.
Now you got to allow the word of God to lead and guide you and to order your footsteps. Amen. So the agreement that you made with the enemy can be broken in the name of Jesus by you ordering, by you walking in truth. Yes, come on. Bye-bye. Pastor James said you got to evict sin. Come on, put that in the comment line. I got to evict sin. Wherever sin resides, I got to evict it. I got to give it a termination letter tonight.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
Thank
you, Lord.
Save me from the harmful people so I can obey your orders. God is saying, listen, you got to tell me to save you from the harmful people that are in your life. Save me from those people that are operating in deception. Those people that don't mean me no good. Those people, amen, they only in my life for what they can do, what they can get from me. Not what they can do for me, what they can get from me. And God calls these people harmful people. Because they don't have your best interests at heart. Glory, hallelujah. Come on, show your kindness to me, your servant. Teach me your demands. See, you got to ask God. One of the things, amen, for God to come and help you while you're standing under pressure, you got to ask God, teach me your demands. Teach me your commands. Teach me what's right. Teach me. Glory, hallelujah. Because I have need to be taught. Because see, when you self-taught yourself, it was not correct teaching. And many of you, amen, glory, you gotta unteach yourself now and ask God to teach you. Teach you what his command is. Teach you what his word is. Teach you, amen,
yes,
his
Lord.
Desire and what he wants for you.
Thank
glory,
you,
hallelujah. Come on, Babasho.
Thank you,
but also let your kindness be shown to me. Tears streaming from my eyes because people do not obey your teachings. God says, listen. He said, when I learn who you are, amen, Mamasho, and when I start obeying you, then tears are going to scream from my eyes. Why? Because then I'm going to see how people have not obeyed your teaching. I'm going to see, amen, how people, amen, has missed, amen, misquoted the scripture. Even how they misrepresented you, God. And so once I learned the truth, then tears start coming down my eyes. And when God began to give me the ear of my shine, when he began to give me the scripture, God says, then when your heart line up with my heart, then he said, I begin to purge you. And you begin to cry. It's because you're crying now for righteousness. You're crying now, amen, for truth. You're crying now, amen, glory, because sin cannot reside in you, and you cannot allow sin to pressure you. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. That's why you just can't tell no lie. Amen. And it sit good in your spirit. Amen. Every time you lie, the Holy Ghost in you ought to convict you. Why? Because to tell a lie is sinful. Glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. The third way, amen. God wants you to empower yourself so you can stand under pressure. Amen. It's to live in righteousness. Come on, y'all need to put it in the comment. I got to live in righteousness. So many people, amen, they say that they're in relationship with God, amen, but one of the things that the enemy tempt them on the most, amen, is to live righteous. That's why the scripture declare, amen, that gifts are talents without repentance. That ain't got nothing. You can be gifted and still living erroneous. Glory, foul, amen. Apostle said foul, amen, glory. You got the Holy Ghost, but you still living foul. You got the Holy Ghost and you still telling lies, amen. You got the Holy Ghost and you still fornicating. You got the Holy Ghost, amen. You still backbiting, you still being a busybody. Glory, hallelujah. But tonight, I come to challenge you, amen, that you got to live righteous. You got to live righteous. So that when the enemy comes to pressure you, amen, you are holy because God is holy. Living in righteousness is imperative in God's eyes for him to fulfill his promises to you. You got to live right because it's imperative to God. The truth is that you cannot expect God to bless you when you willfully break his commandments. Come on now. Y'all need to stop expecting God to bless you and to release the promises he has promised you, amen, when you don't even live right. Glory. The question is, what do God say about being righteous? Jesus asserted the importance of righteousness by saying Matthew 5:20. I tell you that if you are no more obedient than the teacher of the law, the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. You will never enter the kingdom of heaven. God said, listen, I tell you that if you are no more obedient than the teachers of the law and the Pharisees. See, God said the Pharisees knew the law, amen, but they couldn't live it. They could not live it. Come on, they couldn't live it. They knew the laws, but they could not live it. And so God is saying, when you don't live this thing, he said, you can't get the promises. You cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven. That's why so many preachers, amen, false preachers and false teachers, amen, got y'all thinking y'all going to heaven when you going to hell.
My God.
Hey. I said it. Because you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven living unrighteous. You got to live righteous. Glory, hallelujah. Why do we need to live righteous? Glory. To make us more like Jesus. Mm-hmm. See, the reason why you got to live righteously is because it makes you more like Jesus. You gotta have the attributes. You gotta have the characteristics. Amen. You should be looking like your father. You should be talking like your father. You should be acting like your father. Mm-hmm. And if you're not, then you acting like the one you serve the most.
That's right.
How you gonna be with Jesus? I'm about my soul and not act like him.
My God.
Why? Why? Because so many times, why do I have to live right? Why I can't do this? Why I can't do that? Because if you believe the word of God, amen, and you're in relationship, then you will want to be, amen, just like your father. Through the power of the Holy Ghost, righteousness allows us to share in the nature of Jesus Christ. The righteousness of Christ does more than save us. Oh, y'all need to put that in there. See, what you fail to realize and the lies that the enemy been telling you all, the righteousness of Christ does more than save us. It helps us to become the person God intended for us to be. See, it does more than just saving.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why, amen, I'm going to say it. Some of y'all can be saved, but you ain't delivered.
That's right. Lord,
you say, but you ain't delivered. Because
mm-hmm.
true deliverance means you're walking in the righteousness of God. You're walking, amen, according to God's statutes. You're walking according to the commandments of God.
Mm-hmm.
Not what nobody think, not what nobody say. You're walking in righteousness because God told you to walk in it.
Right.
Be holy because I am holy. Right. Ephesians 5 and 8. Glory, hallelujah. Glory to his name. Come on.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians 5 and 8. Glory. Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. In the past, you were full of darkness, but now you are full of the light in the Lord. So live like the children who belong to the light.
Mm-hmm.
God is saying, listen, glory. In the past, he know you came out and you were full of darkness.
Yes.
But now since you've been living right, now that you've been introduced to me, now you're full of my power and my authority. God said, now you gotta live in the light.
Yes.
You gotta so live like the children who belong to the light.
Mm-hmm.
That's why God said, that light and darkness don't have any fellowship. Once you come to your senses, once you know who you are in Christ, you no longer have fellowship with the things that is not of God. And it's not hard. But again, that comes through deliverance. Our apostle talked about, amen, did you get your vitamin D? You need to be asking God for vitamin D every day. You need to be asking God to give you deliverance. You need to be asking God, amen, to deliver you from the things that you know that are not like God. Because you need it.
That's right.
If you're going to make it into the kingdom, amen. Listen, y'all, it ain't about what you have now.
Mm-hmm.
It's about where you're going. See, most of y'all so worried about what you got. What you don't have. Even during this holiday season, don't go and get in debt. Amen. Because this is not what it's about. Amen. Get your life right with Christ. Glory, hallelujah. I'd rather, amen, receive the gift of life. Amen. The gift of joy. Amen. The gift of peace.
Mm-hmm.
The gift of love. Then for somebody to give me a gift that don't even like me. Amen. And it's given me, but because of a hidden motive.
Mm-hmm.
Glory. Number four. Amen. My last point. Amen. While you're standing under pressure. Amen. You got to walk in humility. You got to walk in humility. When God said this to me, amen, he was giving me this today. One of the things that the enemy tries to pressure us, amen, while we're standing under pressure, is one of the things that the enemy loves to make false accusations against us. The enemy loves, amen, to say things about us, amen, that is not true, amen. And the reason he does this, amen, no matter what the enemy is because the enemy is trying to get you to operate in your flesh. The enemy is trying to get you, amen, glory, it's to fight with him, amen, an unfair fight by using words. The enemy then began to get in a word battle with you. And so that's why God said, tell them, amen, glory, that while they are going through, amen, they're standing under pressure, amen, and when the enemy makes a false accusation against you, the Lord said, be humble yourself.
Glory to God.
Don't even respond back. Don't even think that you got a counter back. Let the enemy say whatever the enemy want to say, amen, and you say a prayer for the enemy, amen. So let's look at Micah 6:8. The Lord has told you, human, what is good. He has told you what he wants from you, to do what is right to other people. Love, babasho, love being kind to others. Live humble, obey your God. In other words, God is saying, listen, during this time when the enemy is trying to use you, amen, to get in your flesh, because when people say stuff, amen, glory, hallelujah, it has the way, amen, of making us emotional, amen. But I want you to know, while you're standing under pressure, amen, you cannot allow your emotion to dictate, amen, when you're going to respond, how you're going to respond. But you got to allow the word of God, amen, to let you walk in humility. Because the plot of the enemy, amen, is to get you to say something. Because some things is being said to you, amen, glory, that you don't like. Some things is being said to you, amen, because all the enemy doing is trying to bait you, amen, into getting into a word battle. So when you fall for that distraction, amen, then the enemy saying, listen, I know how I'm going to get Apostle Venus. I know how I'm going to get Apostle James. I'm going to say something about them that they used to do.
My God.
I'm going to say some things about them. But again, that's what you used to do. That was to owe you. Now that you have, you're walking in the light, amen, and you repented for your past, amen, don't allow the enemy to make you get in a word battle. What you got to do is humble yourself. I believe in the book of James. James talks about resist the devil, amen, and he shall flee from you. Humble yourself. Resist the devil, amen, and he shall flee from you, amen. Proverbs, amen. Come on, God said, tell them they need to put on Proverbs 15:1. Glory, hallelujah. He said, a gentle answer will calm a person's anger, but an unkind answer will cause more anger. Sometimes, amen, it's best for you, amen, just to say something sweet. You know when a person is angry. You know when a person, amen, is acting out of character. There's no need for you to say anything, because when you do, it's only going to stir up a bigger mess. So don't play in the hand of the enemy. While God is using, amen, the breaker's anointing to break the power of the enemy that tries to put you under pressure. By what? By making you have a word battle.
My God.
Humble yourself. Humble yourself, man of God. Humble yourself, woman of God. Let them say whatever they want to say, and God will deal with it. Because the word of God says, vengeance is mine, thus said the Lord, I shall repay. Amen. Glory. I'm here to tell you, God wants you to be able to stand under pressure. And when the enemy think that he got you, you're standing on the word of God. You're standing on these principles. And as you stand on these principles, God is gonna break that pressure, amen. And God is gonna put an anointing on you, God is gonna put an authority on you. So don't worry about the enemy, look at what God is doing in you. Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
James 4 and 10. James 4 and 10. I'm here to tell you that God is going to do it. And so that's why James 4 and 2 say, humble yourself in the Lord's presence and he will honor you. Hey, Baba Basho. Oh, my God, when you humble yourself, God says he in his presence. God know that they're not right. God know that the enemy did not play fair. But God don't want you to stoop to the same tactics as the enemy. And God say, I will honor you. Amen. But there's another translation. God said, he will exalt you. God said, once you've gone through this test, and you're proving yourself to me, God said, when you humble yourself, amen, when you didn't allow the enemy, amen, to make him think that he was going to catch you up in a word battle, God said, I'm going to honor you. Not only am I going to honor you, I'm going to exalt you. Amen. God said, I'm going to promote you. Again, my apostle, he came on this broadcast and he said that the Lord said, reminding him today that it is your time and it is your turn. And so God said, I'm giving you strategies in the name of Jesus to stand under the pressure, under the bosho, to stand under the pressure. While I make you, while I release the breakers anointing upon you, while I release a double portion authority upon you, and in the name of Jesus, because when the word of God goes forth, it goes forth like a hammer that's on fire, and it breaks it, it breaks everything into pieces that's not like God. But God is trying to teach you, my dear sister, my dear brother, how to stand under pressure and to look the devil in the eye and let the devil know that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. And in the name of Jesus, I was made for this. I was designed for this. God has caused a breaker's anointing to be upon me. I walk in a yoke-destroying anointing. I sleep in a yoke-destroying anointing. I live in a yoke-destroying anointing. And nothing that the enemy can do can touch me. Glory, hallelujah. But I come to break the influences. I come to break and tear down every wall. I come to break the forces of darkness, not only up of my life, but up of my family life, up of my purpose, up of my business, up of my church, in the name of Jesus. He come down on my shoulder, down on my shoulder, and I'm going to stand. I see him under the show. I'm going to stand until I see God move. I'm going to stand until he bring me through. I'm going to stand and see the breaking and the strategies of the enemy.
Thank you, Lord.
Won't make me be quiet.
Yes, Lord.
The strategies
yes, God.
Of the enemy won't make me bow down. Because the word of the Lord said that every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. I come to decree tonight, you're going to be able to stand under pressure when you see God. You're going to be able to stand under pressure when you obey God. When you live in righteousness, you're going to be able to stand under pressure. Glory, hallelujah. When you walk in humility, you're going to be able to stand under pressure. Amen. Glory. When you walk in truth, when you walk in love, when you walk in forgiveness, in the name of Jesus, there is an anointing, there is an authority that will rest upon your life that the enemy cannot touch you. My apostle also started this broadcast. He said, I won't stop. I can't stop. Every time the enemy see me, the enemy will run. Glory, hallelujah. For the Lord is on my side, and I'm coming prepared to fight. I'm coming prepared. So I declare to you tonight, loose in the name of Jesus. I command you to be set free tonight in the powers of darkness. Don't have any authority. Satan, I command you in the name of Jesus. Release them now in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. I won't fall in this season.
Thank you, Lord.
I come to declare you won't fall in this season.
Yes, God.
I come to declare that you won't be made ashamed of. Whatever God purposed for you in this season, you shall get it in the name of Jesus. It's my turn. It's my time. It's my turn.
Yes,
glory,
Lord.
Hallelujah. And God has allowed you to go through this pressure. Glory, hallelujah. So something can break in you. I don't know about you, but any unrighteousness, anything that's not of God, that's in my life, that's been a thorn in my life, it has to go tonight in the name of Jesus. Glory, hallelujah. And I know that God is going to exalt us. I know, amen, that the battle is already won.
Yes,
come on and shout glory.
You,
come on and shout glory.
You,
come on
Lord.
And shout glory.
Thank
come
you.
On, come on, come on, come on. Come
thank
on
you,
and
Lord.
Shout glory, because God is giving you victory. I don't care in what area. God is giving you victory in every area of your life.
Thank
God
you,
wants
Lord.
To manifest himself. God wants to show himself supreme
yes,
in
Lord.
Your life.
Thank
so
you,
I want to encourage you tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
Stand under pressure.
Jesus.
Stand under pressure.
Jesus.
And use the word of God as your
hallelujah.
Weapon. Come on, doro do boko bashata. I want to challenge those of you, amen. Don't allow the enemy to use you in this season. Don't allow the enemy, mama mancha, make you stay, amen. Don't allow the enemy make you stay under pressure to an unrighteous God. Glory, hallelujah. Come on, it's offering time in the sanctuary. Come on, it's offering time. And listen, I got to challenge you. Amen. I got to challenge you. Amen. If you saying that it's my time, it's my turn. Glory, hallelujah. Come on, I'm telling you to join in with us tonight. Amen. And plant a seed. Those of you, amen, that can plant a seed. Or two $22. Come on, I'm already decreeing $22. We are already decreeing, amen, that the year 22, amen, it's going to be your time. It's going to be your turn. And so I want you to stand with me, because this seed tonight, we're planting a seed, amen, a yoke-destroying anointing seed, amen, and we're planting it towards your future. We're planting it towards your future tonight. So as many of you that can plant a seed, I heard the Lord say 22. I know God has said to me, amen, that what the year 22 is going to be, but I declare double return unto you in the name of Jesus. And as our apostle said, amen, come on and plant a seed tonight of $22. Glory, hallelujah. For those of you, amen, that's married, those of you, amen, even those of you that got businesses, and you want God to do something in your business, come on, you need to plant a seed for your business. You need to plant a seed. But I'm asking the couples, amen, come on, tonight, Apostle James and I will be planting $44. Amen. Because I'm believing God for exponential growth. I'm believing God for certainly. I'm believing God. So if that be you tonight, plant the seed tonight and watch God move. Watch God word. Come into fruition. And there are three ways you can give. Three ways you can give. The first way you can give, amen, is $ through Cash App. That's $. NEWBFMC. Come on, $ new BFMC. Amen. Or you can give it through PayPal. Amen. That's finance at nbfmc.org. Come on, give that seed, plant that seed tonight. Amen. Amen. Or the third way you can give, amen, if you don't have Cash App, you don't have PayPal, you can mail a check or money order. Make it payable to New Beginning Faith Ministry Church. Mail it to P.O. Box 143, amen, Palmetto, Georgia 30268. I want to challenge you tonight. You need to plant a seed. And stand on the word of God. Glory. Because I am a prophet of the Lord. Amen. And whenever the Lord speaks, I say what God says. Amen. And you should see the manifestation. Glory. Hallelujah. So you need to plant this seed. If you need God to do something in your business, you do it. But I do hear the Lord say that there is three people on here. You need God to move. He said, I'm telling you to plant the seed that I told you to plant. Amen. And that seed may be more than $22, but you know who you are. God said, plant the seed and watch me move.
Thank you, Lord.
Plant the seed. Plant the seed and watch me move.
Thank you, Jesus.
Plant the seed and watch me move. Amen. Glory. We honor God tonight. Oh my God, I'm so fired up because God has given us strategies. Amen. That the enemy think, amen, that he has you under pressure. Yes. But God said, I'm going to teach you how to stand under pressure. Amen. First of all, I've told you, amen, pressure comes with ministry, but I'm going to teach you how to stand under pressure. I'm going to teach you. And he said, and my word would not return unto you void. But as a matter of fact, if you stand on the word is going to bring victory in every area of your life.
Lord,
we
you,
declare
Lord.
Victory tonight
yes,
in the
God.
Name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Glory. Hallelujah. We declare victory. Glory. Join us again, amen, on Sunday morning. Amen. For those of you, amen, that would like to visit us, amen, we will be live, amen, in-person services at New Beginning Faith Ministry Church. That's 1067 Highway 29 South, 30263. We will be in the ministry on Sunday morning. Amen. And the video show, the intercessors, amen, will start praying at 10:30. Amen. And the word of God shall go forth. Amen. The services shall go forward. Yes, amen. At 11 a.m. Amen. Come on and be our special guest. Come on and see another video show what the Lord is doing. Amen. And it's marvelous in his sight. So tonight we thank you for tuning in. Amen. And on Baba Shada the video show. And on behalf of Apostle James and the New Beginning Faith Ministry Church, amen, family, amen. We want to bid you all happy holidays. Amen. Be safe. Use wisdom. Amen. Glory. Baba show. But remember, amen, to seek the Lord. Remember, amen, to stand on his word. Amen. And we're going to see God do it. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. So in the name of Jesus, we bless you. Amen. And we love you. And until we meet you again, be blessed. And by the way, the church is still open. Praise the name of the Lord. We love you and be blessed in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.